got Nick on the line in North Dakota listening on Real Presence Radio. Hi, Nick. Thanks for your patience during the break. Go ahead.
Hey, so thanks for taking my call. Sure. I was just wondering, if purgatory is good for our souls and helps us be ordered towards God, why do we want to get out of purgatory faster?
No, this is a very good question, Nick. Well, keep in mind, the good of purgatory, number one, is that the souls there can no longer sin. So that's a source of joy that's going to be present there. And secondly, the souls in purgatory are guaranteed their salvation. They're on their way to heaven. There's no possible way for them to go to hell. And that, secondly, is a source of joy in purgatory. However, purgatory and this final purification is also going to be a cause of suffering. It will be a great suffering in this final purification that goes far beyond what we can even imagine, Nick, in this life. You know, in fact, St. Thomas Aquinas, in Appendix 1, Question 2, Article 1, he quotes St. Augustine saying this, Nick, check this out. "This fire of purgatory," Augustine says, "will be more severe than any pain that can be felt, seen or conceived in this world." So St. Augustine and the saints after him would all talk about how painful the final purification will be. Although there is joy there, yes, it will entail great suffering as well. It won't be the suffering of the damned, of the wicked who will go to eternal damnation. The church makes that clear. There's a distinct experience. I can't get the words out here. They're different punishments, as the church talks about in the Catechism of the Catholic Church. So there will be great suffering. So, Nick, taking into consideration that the suffering of purgatory will be intense, it would be a good thing to have a desire for that final purification to come to completion as quick as possible. And that's why it's important for us here on earth who are united to those souls in purgatory to pray for them, to offer our sufferings for them, in order that those graces, God can apply those graces to those souls and bring their final purification to completion. And keep in mind this, Nick, one of the reasons why the suffering of purgatory will be so intense compared to any sort of suffering we experience in this life is because in purgatory, those souls are going to, their intellects, their minds will be enlightened by God so that they will know what they are going to receive. And the pain or the suffering arises from the fact that although they know what is awaiting for them with a fuller knowledge than what we have now, they can't have it yet. So that great desire for heaven, that great longing for the beatific vision, but yet they still can't have it, that, the tradition says, is one of the sources of the suffering, one of the causes of the suffering in purgatory. Whereas for us, Nick, here on earth, man, we're told that heaven's great. Yeah, it's going to be the perfection of truth and life and all of this fun stuff. And, you know, the Bible uses some great images, as Jesus does in Matthew 8, of a great feast and a banquet with folks coming from east and west sitting down with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's all fine and dandy. But that's sort of a limited knowledge. We're looking in a distorted mirror, you might say, as St. Paul would talk about. We only know in part, but those souls in purgatory, they're going to receive an enlightenment of the mind to know what is awaiting for them. And because they can't have it, that's going to cause a great deal of suffering for them. So out of love for us, Nick, we want to pray for those souls so that their final purification can be complete so that they can enter into the joy and the glory of heaven so that their suffering can come to a completed state and be finished.
Well said, Karlo. Thanks, Nick, for the phone call. Appreciate that very much.